Don't release it until it is finished. You're gonna hear me say that a lot in this video. I'm gonna drum that into Evil Mojo's head until they understand what that phrase means. Take a look at this. This is the Alpha Speeder mount. It is one of two vehicle mounts in one of my favourite games, slash punching bag, slash grindfest, Paladins. That game I keep complaining about because, shockingly, I actually like it, and I personally want the game to be as good as it can be. I've said that exact thing twice now, and I still mean it. Normally, for all those not in the know, the game uses mounts to get you to the start of the battle at the start of the round, and for when you die. Normally, they are horse-related mounts, such as these lovely specimens. Also one nicked from Smite, which is technically a panther, but whatever, don't think we wouldn't notice. Now, to literally any credible company, you'd think that before releasing such an item, a new type of mount, which requires recreating a new set of animations for each character, you'd think they would, oh, I don't know, finish doing exactly that, creating animations for each character for the mount, before they started selling it to you, or rather as part of the premium portion of the battle passes. Well, clearly Evil Mojo thought otherwise, and on release, anyone who bought it got a stiff, non-animated, larger than normal vehicle mount, a new type of mount that was harder to control than a bloody shopping trolley, and for once, that's a literal metaphor. It actually means blood-stained wheels on a shopping trolley. When a character sits on top of the mount, they're as solid as a rock. Not moving in any way, with no idle animation, no reactions to jumping, no steering left, right, or anything else. And Evil Mojo thought that was fine to release as it was. Kinda shows to you what they think about you as customers, doesn't it? The vehicle mounts do not have character animations, for whatever reason, though my bet is on not caring, but that's not important. No, we had to push out Battle Pass 4 with a new type of mount because we needed to create some buzz for it, and there is no better way of doing that than releasing something unique that we've never done before. Lord be damned that it actually be finished before we release it. That's an afterthought, apparently. Clearly. Well, here's something you should learn, Evil Mojo, and just Tyrus in general. Don't release it until it is finished. You can make the excuse of saying they can patch in newer animations post-release for the vehicle mounts. We do indeed live in a post-patch world where these things can be patched in. Firstly, this is the kind of thing that shouldn't need be patched in at a later date, because you shouldn't release something until it's finished. And second, that hasn't really happened. The mount itself did actually get some animations to make it vibrate so it no longer feels like I'm hauling a gravestone. But the characters, they still haven't got animations, they're still stiff, which still makes the mount hard to control. This is an issue from a moral standpoint. Selling players unfinished goods is not something any company should be happy about doing, and no, for once I'm not talking about early access games, do not try and use that against me. Though early access games are deliberately unfinished, that's a very different thing. It is an issue from a gameplay standpoint, in that because the right amount of information is not being delivered to your lovely sweaty eyeballs, it makes the mount quite a lot harder to control. Even if the mount itself has the same controls, it feels different to control. Let me explain this a bit better by giving you a visual example. This is a horse that uses the standard animations. All characters have animations for it, so let's take Pip for example. Pip will react accordingly as to whether or not he's idling, moving forward, jumping, falling, and landing. They even have an extended animation for when they're riding on their horse for a while. This gives visual information to the player that yes, Pip is indeed riding this mount in a given direction and or for a given amount of time. He leans forwards when riding forwards and reacts to outside stimuli, such as the aforementioned jumping, falling, and landing. This is helpful to maintain the feeling of controlling something that feels, you know, there or alive because it's a horse. It serves the player by bringing you deeper into the game world so you can focus more on the riding and where to go, rather than how it feels to control, because after a while of using the horse mount, you know how the character reacts and how to ride on those sorts of mounts. In a nutshell, it feels good to use. The same cannot be said for the vehicle mounts. The vehicle mounts, in this case both the 8-bit rider and the Alpha Speeder, the one I mentioned earlier, what an appropriate name by the way, it really does feel like it belongs in an alpha of a game. The vehicle mounts are nothing like the horse mounts. It faces the exact same direction, no matter which button you press, which is really annoying, and as mentioned earlier, the characters don't react at all to the mount they're on or how you move it, and frankly, they just look unfinished, sloppy, and broken. You know, like as if they belonged in an alpha. Pip doesn't react to the mount's actions, meaning it feels really, really awkward to control, like, again, controlling a bloody wheel chopping trolley. He's static in the middle with little more effort than a T-pose to seemingly make him look like he's riding it, but in actuality, he's not. Here, he's as stiff as a statue. There is almost zero player information being conveyed visually as the characters do not react, and because they don't react to the outside stimuli, it looks unnatural, which is pretty much the reason why idle animations exist. It looks unnatural if they just stand with nothing, without doing anything. It's very weird. So, say it with me now. Don't release it until it is finished. There is no excuse that anyone can come up with that'll convince me to drop this, by the way. I'm actually 70% sure that you intended for these mounts to be like this. In fact, considering the Thunderbrush back in January of 2019, 7 months ago now as of recording this, showed off some animations he and his team were working on for fixing it up, I am 90% convinced they released the mounts early to then do the character animations later, because that's totally acceptable practice in an online game. And also, to be fair to Thunderbrush, the hunt started. Meaning, bug fixing took precedent, which makes sense of course. I want Terminus fixed as much as anyone else, among other things I could mention. But, this is a very big but, unless I'm missing something, animators don't tend to be the same folks as quality assurance encoders. I mean, I'd imagine there could be some overlap, I won't rule that out. So, unless your team is so small that these cannot be fixed in any time frame people could consider reasonable, which is to say no time frame would be reasonable, as it shouldn't have been released to begin with without being finished first, but other than that, you have a serious staff problem. Call me old-fashioned, but I like buying stuff that isn't half-baked. That's why I don't have the 8-bit rider, because I knew we wouldn't have animations for the characters. And secondly, I felt a little bit insulted that you had the gall, the balls, and the kahunas to release a second unfinished vehicle mount so close after releasing the first one. As if that'll make the situation any bloody better. It didn't, obviously. It made it clear that you don't care about it. This was your way of saying, screw you, here's another one you'll inevitably buy. Which, by the way, didn't really work, because the Battle Bike Battle Pass was hilariously grindy to begin with, and the 8-bit rider was the unripe cherry on a very mouldy out-of-date cake. Didn't work. And I get the feeling you're not doing Battle Pass mounts for a while because you know it's broken, and you learned too late that adding fuel to the unfinished mount fire probably wasn't a great idea. It's been 7 months, 2 skin events, 1 story event, a 7-month bug hunt that's continuing on for the rest of the year, and no animations added to the Alpha Speed mounts, or the 8-bit rider, they share the same animation set. This is yet another sour grape I have to swallow when it comes to Evil Mojo. In fact, this entire situation is a pretty damn good analogy for how Evil Mojo releases their content. We'll fix it later if you buy it now. Well, sorry, but I'd like to think you're running out of Gaugel free cards with us, considering your bug hunting program has barely made a dent in the game's problems. Just for the record, I'm not poo-pooing the actual work that has gone into it. Genuinely really good stuff, but, you know, barely made a dent. And more importantly, you don't have faith in this game. Have you ever wondered why this game has very little merchandise? I get the feeling that lack of faith in your product is why. If you wanted your product to succeed, then you would advertise it a hell of a lot more, you know, with merchandise and adverts. But that doesn't happen, really. The game on PC is losing players about 2,000 each month, according to Steam Charts data, and the game's unfinished feeling is probably why. I could be wrong, of course. It could be because they want to monetize the ever-waning niche audience, which is why these 800 crystal stins exist, which is totally what we asked for. We didn't, by the way.
I never asked for this.
We wanted all the skins to be paid, at an actual reasonable price, not 800 crystals, which, for any context, no skin costs that. That is the most expensive single purchase skin in the game, other than unlimited tier skins, which are, they're event exclusive, and they're like 1200, 1300 crystals, and even those are too expensive, in my opinion. So one more time, and I want a response, Evil Mojo, don't release it until it is finished. Thank you for listening.